Kobe, morning.
Good morning.
Hey, buddy. You have siblings?
I do. I have two.
Two. Are you oldest of all of them?
I'm the middle child.
Middle child. Explains a lot, doesn't it?
Puts a big puzzle piece in.
Yeah, look at you.
Yes.
A forgotten child.
I'm dead smack in the middle. Brother's 5 years older. My sister's 4 years younger.
Okay. Damn, so they spread them out, huh?
Yeah.
Mom and dad get it in.
Now, I don't mean to get... I think I may have found this out. My brother says it's true. I don't know if it's true, but I think I may have been an accident. Like, I think my parents were only planning on having one,
mm-hmm.
and then I came along. So if there's a five-year gap, mm-hmm. were you planned or were you, like, a happy surprise?
I was planned. I'd tell my sister she was accident.
So she was definitely. They were like, all right, we're good at two. And then three comes along like, wow.
Yeah, guess what? Yeah, sometimes, God, the human reproductive system. My aunt and uncle couldn't conceive. They could not. They tried for years. Mm-hmm. They adopt a child from Korea. My incredible cousin, Christopher. 2 weeks later, she's pregnant.
There you go.
And I mean, they tried for years, and the minute that they got this beautiful bouncing baby boy on its way from Seoul, they have my cousin Louise.
So now, yesterday, did you take it upon yourself to do this, or is this something you do? You're out and about having your day, doing your thing. Little sis says, "Hey, my boyfriend is going to swing by."
You say, oh.
And then you go, oh, okay. You immediately head home because you wanted to be there to somewhat supervise. Now, is that normal procedure or – because I have friends that have children that are older, that are in the age where you start to explore. There's a universe underneath that blanket.
Oh, yeah. There's an entire mysterious realm behind the zipper.
Mm-hmm. And they oftentimes, I've seen them like leave, you know, get-togethers, being like, oh, we got to go because so-and-so's coming over and we want to be
mm-hmm.
in it. You just want that presence. And you did that yesterday, and I respect that. You went home and you kind of...
looking after a little sis.
Showed the big bro presence, like, hey, just so you know, I'm here. Like, so don't be trying no funny biz.
I'm not front kicking the door open,
but...
Just know.
Yeah, just know.
I am somewhere within earshot of whatever funny business you do. If I hear the sound of churning butter, I'm walking in.
Yep. That's absolutely what it is. I'm also bigger than him as well.
So
the first time I met him, I was like, hey, what's up? What's going on? Like, dropped the bass in my voice and everything.
Kobe's hard-ass voice that he occasionally will hit you with is startling. We will do something similar with my stepson. I love him. Sweet Gav. But he's got a girlfriend. And she comes over and she hangs out. We've got a no-closed-doors policy in the house. She can come hang out all she wants.
Mm-hmm.
But every 20 to 30 minutes... We deploy Evan.
That's hilarious.
We send Evan in. I mean, we'll pull him aside. Buddy, psst, come here. I got a mission for you. I need you to go, and I need you to get your Nerf bow and arrow set out of the closet, which we know is buried behind a bunch of crap. And it just, he never knows. And sometimes we'll make the intervals 3 minutes apart.
Yeah, you keep them on their toes.
Never knows. Yeah, it might be 5 minutes, might be 30 minutes. So you're in the house.
Yes.
They're back there. You're doing that voice. What's your relationship like with the boyfriend? Is he cautious around you?
He's nice. He's sweet. He's a good guy.
He knows he has to be.
Yeah, he knows he has to be. He's a good guy. He talked about church a lot yesterday, but I don't know him like that.
Yeah.
So I have a little bit of a guard up, but I'm very nice to him as well.
Yeah, I feel like oftentimes we always skew like negative, or you want to hate these kids, or you want to maybe put fear in them, or you're like, oh, who's this son of a bitch? But there are nice, good kids out there.
There are great children out there.
You know? Yeah. And he could be one of those.
I count my kids amongst those, that you should be so lucky to have one of my three date your horrible progeny. Speaks, growing up, you had sisters. Did they date in high school at all?
No,
not really.
No,
they were pretty studious.
Yeah, and they went to these Orthodox Jewish schools where dating was frowned upon. Okay, and no, there was no evidence of dating.
Nobody, so you didn't have to square up. You didn't be.
No.
You weren't the sibling that answered the front door.
No.
What are your intentions for my sister?
No, nothing like that.
Do you know I had that legit question asked to me by a father when I was 16 years old? I went, there was this girl named Wendy Shook, and boy, I was shook when I met her dad, and literally at the front door, just, "You're Justin?" "Yes, sir." "What are your intentions for my daughter?" "Sex."
Yeah, right. What do you say?
"Sex." "That's it. I want to show her that I can do a kickflip and hope it leads to sex. I'll leave now." So you keep your presence known.
I like it.
Yep. Scott says your presence is a present, and everything on the up and up.
I'd say so. Yes.
Never and had to intervene.
No. Never. I think something else that
is there a rule? Is there an overarching rule in the house when it comes to the, like? Are they?
You touch her, I touch you.
I think the, like, main
has
thing
there been we, a, can I just say, like, has there been a rule that's like no sex in the house, or well, like, well, is well, there
front yard
well,
only?
We no one really comes over the house. Like, more recently, we've been having people over. I think the main reason why, like, we're kind of more like on the nicer end of things is because my brother, me, my little sister, we don't bring anyone around unless we know they're like a good person. They're going to be around for a minute. So that's like the main thing.
What's the rule in the Reardon household growing up? Ma and pa, bring a lady over, high school girlfriend. Did you go
over
there?
I didn't really have many girlfriends. I was a failure to launch in that department.
So Ron and Rita didn't have to worry about.
No,
Scotty. I just what's all that banging?
It was me masturbating.
Scotty.
I'm very bad with women. I didn't really have a lot of women.
Sounds like you're in there punching a side of beef.
That's not true. I could have had a lot of women, and I'm not bragging. Like, it's just high school. You know what I mean? They're around, and there were a lot of cute girls. I can name a few that, but I was just too, scared.
My dad absolutely
was just too scared.
Walked in on me with a girlfriend, and it was, I used to tell this on stage, and shocker, much like many of my long-form bits, never really went anywhere. But the old man. Hey, next time that Jerry calls in, Joe, okay, that bit is long since been figured out. Jerry called earlier in the week, and I didn't put him through. Sorry, Dad. But my girlfriend and I skipped school. And in the sun-bathed bedroom of mine, thinking no one would be home, we were engaged in the act. And my dad, who decided to take a half day down at the job site, I guess the foreman really had a hair up his ass. He swings open the door to my bedroom. "Justin, I'm thinking about getting a pizza." "Oh, God! Oh, God! He doesn't leave. He turns his back.
He just turned around and was like, "Oh, you want to tell your lady friend that we're thinking about getting a pizza? I'm thinking about getting a, I don't know, by the looks of it, a meat lover's."
Pork.